Greetings, everyone. This is Quantum Unicorn. Welcome to my channel. Please join me on this remarkable journey as we explore the world of stock trading and financial analysis using the powerful programming language, Python. I'm excited to share my knowledge and insights with you as we delve into the exciting and dynamic field of stock trading modeling and financial analysis. I look forward to embarking on this journey with you and creating a vibrant community of like-minded individuals. Let's make the most of this opportunity to learn and grow together. Welcome aboard. In today's video, I will show you how to import CSV format stock data files into Jupyter Notebook and save it into data frame structure. The very first step of financial data analysis is to get data. I have saved a few tech companies' historical stock price data for educational purpose. Well, actually, this entire series is for educational purpose. As you can see, there are 6 files in CSV format. Please feel free to download them by clicking the link in the description. Okay, I have created a folder on my computer to store the files. The folder is named Data. Friends, it's crucial to keep things organized. Those extra work will make your life so much easier. Now, let me open my Jupyter Notebook. As you can see, Jupyter runs in a browser. I have created a project named Stock Trading Model. In this project, there's a folder. In the folder, I have uploaded the 6 CSV files to here. You can upload your files simply by clicking here. Let's go back to the project page. Oh, and also there's a Python file. And to create a new folder or a file, I will just click on new up here at the top right. And you can choose whatever suits your purpose. And I use Python 3 to create a Python file. See? And you can rename the file simply by clicking here. Now we are in our Python file and ready to start using pandas. Actually, we have to import pandas in the notebook before we use any functions or data structure from pandas. And obviously not the Chinese panda, but the data analysis tool pandas. We can import this by saying import pandas as PD. And PD is short for pandas. Now, importing pandas as PD is just a common convention when using pandas. So let's run that. And if you want to use any modules or functions from pandas, you can simply type PD function name or PD module name. And I run that cell by pressing Shift and Enter. And again, I'm not going to go into these specifics of working here within Jupyter in this series. But I will definitely do a video about the features and the shortcuts in Jupyter Notebook in the near future. So for the rest of this video, we will see how to load in our data and look at some information about that data. Our data is in a CSV format. So in order to read in that CSV, we can simply say FB, which is going to stand for Facebook. Now Facebook has changed its name to Meta, just to be clear. And we are going to say FB is equal to pd.read_CSV. And we are going to use a read CSV method from a pandas here. And now we just want to pass in a path to our CSV file. Now, mine was within the data folder. So the data_CSV is the folder name and facebook.csv is the file I want to import this time. By the way, a kind reminder, if you don't want to upload CSV files to your Jupyter Notebook environment, you can also use the absolute path of the files to import the data. See, This is the address of the file where I stored them on my local computer. Both ways work. Okay. Okay. So now if I hit shift and enter, then that will run that cell. We can see that this is pretty simple to work with. So when using native Python, in order to read in a CSV file, we need to use the CSV module to create a CSV reader and things like that. But here we are just doing this all in one line. So when it reads this in, it's going to read it in as a data frame. So data frames are pretty much the backbone of pandas. And we will go over data frames and the series objects in depth in the future. But for the basics, a data frame is basically just rows and columns of data. We can see what a data frame looks like just by printing it out. And this is a great thing about using Jupyter Notebooks because it allows us to visualize these things in ways that we cannot do in other editors. So here in Jupyter, I can simply just say FB and run that, and it will print out a data frame here. So we didn't even need to wrap this here in a print function. Now, if you are using a normal editor, you can still print out a data frame information, but it's not going to look as good as it does here in Jupyter, where we get this interactive table. So this is a small look at our data. Now that is actually 708 rows and 7 columns here. But if I scroll through these, it doesn't look like there's actually 708 rows printed out here. So this is actually concatenated by default, just to give us a broad overview of the data. By default, Jupyter is displaying 10 rows and 20 columns from our data frame. But how did I know that there were 780 rows for this data frame? There are a few attributes and methods that we can use to get an idea of what our data looks like. So first, we have the shape attribute, and shape gives us a number of rows and columns in a tuple form. In our next cell here, I am going to say fb.shape. This is an attribute here. It's not a method. So you don't want to put parentheses. If I run the cell, we can see that we have 700 rows and 7 columns, and 780 rows and 7 columns. Now, if you want a bit more information, then we can use the info method. The info method will give us the number of rows and columns, and also all of the data types of all the columns as well. If I do fb.info, this actually is a method, so we do want to put the parentheses there. And let me run this row. Let me run this cell. And now it's going over. Let's go over this output so we can see here. It says that we have 780 entries, and we have a total of 7 columns, right? So in our CSV file that we have loaded now, it also gives us the data types of each of these columns. And we are going to go over data types in a future video, but for the most part, objects usually mean strings. And then we have other themes as well. So int 64 is just an integer. A float is a decimal number, and there are no other data types in this data file. There are more data types in general. I will be sure to do a video on data type specifically in the near future, okay? But when we look at our data frame, it tells us we have 780 rows. But we don't see all of them. Obviously, the rows are being concatenated here. I probably don't want to print out all 780 rows, but I do want to see the first 50 rows. Here is what we can do. First, we need to type pd.set_option and parentheses and display.max_rows and 100. And let me run the cell. It shows nothing, but internally, this line of code has already told Jupyter to show 100 rows each time when we want to see the data frame. So this is a new, this will be the new default. Okay, and then we type fb.head 50. And if I run the cell, you will see the 50, you will see the first 50 rows of the file. Now you know that we can pass in a value if you want to see a certain number of values. And now if you want to see the last rows instead of the first rows, then we can use the tail method instead. So if we say fb.tail 15, and Jupyter returns the last 15 rows of the CSV files for us to view. Okay, this is a brief overview of loading our data into Jupyter and how to read this in. In a future video, we are going to learn about filtering data frames and see how we can just grab a specific row where the column equals a certain value. And just a kind reminder, when using the Jupyter notebook, be sure you run the code sequentially from the first block. And this is to ensure that all packages and corresponding CSV files can be installed and imported properly before practicing other codes. Okay, so that's all for today. Congratulations on finishing this tutorial. My aim is to bring you closer to the financial success that you have always aspired for. I invite you to join me on this journey by subscribing to my channel and clicking the bell icon on to receive the latest updates. If you have any inquiries or concerns, don't hesitate to reach out and leave a comment. And in our next video, we will explore the details of methods and attributes of data frame. Thank you for your time, and I look forward to connecting with you soon. Goodbye.